Okay. Think I'm good. Listen, you. Enjoy the 80s pop. Or 80s Japanese pop, I guess that's what it's called. All right. Okay, so delete these for now. All right, free layouts. So HUD. Going through, we have container for entry selection. Container for elements for entry selection, container for rendering. For rendering, this is how we would have our backgrounds and such. So let's see. We use the basic set. Let's see what we got. Okay, so we'll just do this for now. I say no. We don't want that, it's gonna mess it up. All right, so none. We'll just do default. Come on. Yeah, made my life easier and just delete it. Delete it and make a new one. All right, so the container for rendering is this. So it's like a background. The only way to have your image stretch properly is make sure that your image is like set up like so. you'll want to make sure it's in window slice, and then I just always put it in 10 and just fill stretch, stretch as it says, but it's really fill stretch. This way it'll render properly. All right, so back to this. We will make... make a container for all this. All right. So we, put that there. And now with the new update, you can lock it in place. So now it won't move. That's a good feature. All right. So entry for selection. This is when your items for a menu system. So right here, container for elements entry selection would, swap. So this is going to be for each element of your menu. So option one. And then entry selection. There we go. All right. All right. So, a menu container does pretty much exactly that. It contains your menus, so you have all your different options here. So when it comes to player and enemy, this is only for battle maps. You can't use this outside of the world. I haven't seen a way to do it yet. I'm pretty sure there's maybe a way, maybe with scripting and whatnot, but you have the top left, you have top right, left, center, right, bottom left, bottom right, balloon, which would connect to your balloon image. Fits balloon, which I'm not sure how that would work. I haven't played with all of these just yet. I've only messed with, honestly, player, enemy, and position. So a little bit more options here. Window image, you can pick like a background image for it. We'll do this just to make it a little bit different. We'll do something different than that. We'll do that. Okay. That's the container. You can fill with specified size as a rectangle. This is if you don't have an image and you just wanted to use a blank image, and you can color it accordingly. You can even color the image as well, accordingly. But we'll leave that white. Additive composition is for... to display it, I think it's just to give it a little bit of transparency. I'm not 100%. So effects are fun. Bakin comes with a couple that you can mess with. So you have, there's one that's, what is it? It has like all of them. Not that one. Oh, I think it's under basic set. Yeah, okay. So this is a whole bunch too. So we'll do that one. Motion during display. This is when it's playing at all times. So we can do like window in, it can be doing that the entire time. To do map text in mini, remember in, out. You don't want to do anything really for display unless you want it to have like a bounce or something. You can make something like that. I know there's one over here for that. No, I didn't start without you. Oops, sorry. Yeah, exactly. You're late. No, you're here, but I had to fix it, and it finally fixed itself. It's a star. Yeah. Go for the stars. Get the stars. Get the stars. All right, catch the stars. All right. So layout animation, honestly, when it comes to like something like a menu something, I would use a message wait. Doesn't matter which one, because this is saying white or black, so it doesn't matter which one. So you can go like this during display, it'll have a nice little bounce. And then disappearance, and you can test that appearance, disappearance. So cool. So hide when menu is open. So this is something you would use if you're on the main game, or when you're in your game and you still want to use the menu system. If you tip this box, it will hide this entire menu while this switch is on when you have the menu open. So here, so if we go like this, make a new custom event real quick. Not attention HUD. Okay. And then apply start only once. Come on. So like when I open the menu, well, it should be disappearing. I don't know why it's not doing that. Huh. Probably because I'm on stream. But anyways, that's another option there. Line up vertically. You can have it line up vertically or horizontally. Number of elements per row or column is changed right here. Your selection image would be like this. We'll do, why not? We'll do info panel. And we'll make it blue just to make it stand out. Okay, you can blink it while it's going. You can have a background image as well, which I'm gonna go ahead and delete. We don't need one because we have that. All right, so here's how you set your probably, I wouldn't doubt it. I bet if I were to move it up top like that, it would work. Let's see real quick. No, huh, that's weird. Oh well, whatever, probably just has to be reported. So back to mini container, the offset X is going to be the location of it. And this is going to be for all of them. You can't change them individually. No, it's only going once. I do automatically start only once. So it shouldn't That shouldn't have anything to do with it. Let's see. All right. Yes, you are the avatar, Harons. All right, so sub panel width is the length of your option, as well as the height. The margin is the space between, and the standard placement is where you would put it. Generally, I would put it center. I'd put everything center, but that's not proper, I guess. I don't know. All right. So option one, this option right here. Here are all the options. You can set a sprite as well here. We have a lot of new actions now. You have close layout, which will close this layout completely. Call common event. Close and call common event, which will do exactly that. You would want to use call common event when you're making a custom menu system, because if you use close and call common event, it's just going to give you a weird flicker. Start from the beginning. I don't know what that does. I guess it starts you from the complete beginning. But you can literally call all of these actions. You can actually call free layouts in between free layouts now. So if I had another free layout here, you would call it from here. You would select the one that you have right here. And then you can hide the container when it's open. So like you could have it on top and it would disappear, or to the side and it would still stay there. Text. So panel. Anytime you want to put text, you'll need to use panel for rendering strings. We'll just put text. Ooh, text. We'll leave it blackish. Okay. And we'll make the offset a little. Oh no, we don't need to mess with the offset. We'll just connect the two. Yes. So that's the best thing about the whole new free layout system, is you can make pretty much any menu system you want now. Text effect is just like normal outline. Use multi-line text. This is when you have, I don't know what you would really want it for, but that's what it's there. You can tip that box. It'll make a whole, if you put a whole line of stuff, it'll, make multiple lines. Clipping with parent container. If you have this unchecked, you can move the text outside of the element and it'll still stay part of it. So like you can move it around and it'll still stay with it. But if you put the switch back on, it'll disappear. You won't be able to see it. And which actually, there's the inactive color, which is probably, I can set the green, which is weird. But yeah, you won't be able to see it because it's outside of the container. All right, so panel for rendering sprites. The sprite, super simple. We'll do 2D cast sets. So we use him. Of course, it's insanely big, so you'd have to shrink it and everything, but you can set the motion normal, or you can have them like happy, happy chit chatty. All right, sprite panel, I delete that. Yeah, hopefully they'll allow multiple fonts one day. Slider operation. This is how you make your bars. So if you need to make a HP bar or whatnot, this is how you would make it. So background image is the image you would pick. Let's do 2D casts. Let's do one from Smile Game Builder. What do they have? Okay. So we'll do that so it gives it like kind of a pill effect. I like that. All right. So battle unselected as well. Again, for the slider image. Frame thickness. Just a frame. So you have to have at least one. You can't have zero, or it will not work. I guess Bakin doesn't allow you to not have it, because the slider will not move at all. I had to learn that the hard way. I was spending hours trying to figure out what the heck was going on with something, and it was the dang slider. Scale X and Y, you can change it. Like how thick and how thin it is just by scale, or you can change it by pixel up here. I'm gonna go ahead, ooh, not that, come on. Make that darker. All right. You kind of can. You just have to set up a cast ID for it. Thumbnail image. I don't see the real purpose for this, but you can have a small little thumbnail next to it. Here, I'll do one real quick. For sprites. We'll try that. So yeah, so it'll connect it to the slider, which is, this one's obscenely huge. display value is text. This you can use if you want. I usually turn it off and make a whole separate text string that shows the HP value. This is the color. The offset is right here. So if you want to move it around, you would do that. You can change the scale of it, but you can't change the layering of it, unfortunately. So like it's always going to be on top and whatnot. The initial value, you always want to set that. Well, I mean, you don't always, but you can set that to zero. Generally, you'll be looking at percentages, so you would want to set this to 100. Parameters reflected in the slider. Okay. So here's where things become fun. So you can use, finally, we can use a variable. But party HP, this you can use this method if you don't want to put the number down. And if you use this method, make sure that you put it in a container of its own. Because if it's in a container of its own, you can work with the management down here. And you can just put, I think it's one, right? For special party members, zero. Okay, so zero would be the leader. So I don't even have to change the number on here. It's always going to go straight to leader. Or if it was another party members, you would do like one. I'll show you a better example of like how I've set up a menu system with my turn-based battle system in a little bit. So maybe a slider. We'll keep you in that container though. Okay. Response range extension. I haven't really played with this one that much yet. You can change the color by value. So say it's about 50% in, you can change the color to like a yellowish. When it's like, say 10%, you can change the A value to like a red, and it will reflect that very smoothly too. Okay, so up here. So, spin operation. I haven't played too much around with this. Where are you? Should be like right somewhere. Probably behind here. Where are you? Spin. Ah, okay, there you are. Okay, so this connects to your honestly, I really don't know what a spin, like I know it's for like pages and whatnot. Let's see, 2D cat, no, basic set. No, not you. There we go. Basic set. All right, so let's see what Smile Game Builder has. All right, let's see. No, not icons. I don't think. No. Oh, there we are. On a left or right. Okay, well, just not there. Can't ever remember. I thought it was in the reserve, but I guess, let's see. Window. Ah, there we go. Arrow right. That's fine, whatever. What a background image. All right, so default window, we'll do that. And then left button image will be... we'll do left stick, left. Although I'm not seeing it reflecting, I don't know. Take it out of this container. Maybe that'll help. Or yeah, maybe it, I think it does have to be part of a menu. Let me see. Okay, so I'm not 100% sure what the spin panel does, but if I figure it out, I'll definitely make a thing separate for it. Title name, this is for your game titles. Your main title, your subtitle. This is how you get your current map name. You would just enter this and it would just go straight there. You can put this anywhere. Or you can honestly just use a string. This is just made, it gives you little quick and easy options. Current play time is just how long you've played. Money in possession is what you have. Unit of currency is your currency that you have. Selected page number of container being operated. So this, I think, okay. So this is when you have, for your menu, it gives you the value of the page that you're on for that menu. So if you had multiple pages, this would be like page one, page two, page three. Like when you have, I said multiple pages. Okay. Maximum number of pages for container being operated. I don't know why you would need that. Simplified map. This actually will make you a map really quick and easy. We're going to take you out of the container. I think it has to be in a container, though, if I'm not mistaken. We'll see. It's in one. So party. So back to the whole container thing. So that was in your render container. That's what that's referring to. Let's see. Boop. So the name of party member according to management number of container. So that is going to be like in here. So 0 is your main cast, 1 is the next person in line, and so on and so forth. You can also just do it this way too. So name of party. So it would be 0. And then you can put the number in there or whatnot. It's whatever you'd like to do. Cancel parts. Kind of all the same. Graphic for moving. I thought this was going to be an actual moving icon, but unfortunately it's not. It's just a full icon of your character. I mean, it looks good. So that's good at least. Like, I thought he was going to be in, like, the weight or walking motion or something, but no, unfortunately not. Party. Kind of all the same. State icon. This is going to be, like I said, I'll go over a little bit more in mine that I've set up recently. Subclass, all the kind of same thing. Attribute icon. So this is attribute, which is like your elements and everything. So that you can put an icon manager for that. Graphic moving selected party member. This is how you would get their net graphic. Current party graphic. Yeah, same thing. Yeah, here. It's all very self-explanatory parts. Reserve. I'm not going to go over too much of the reserve because I haven't messed with the reserves yet. Save data. So this is how you can break down everything in the save menu. Like it literally breaks it all down. Like if you want to have your own custom like save menu and everything, you would have to edit all that. Items. I haven't really messed with that either. skills, all kind of the same thing. This is how you would set up like how much, like a plus or a minus of like how much it's gonna consume or whatnot, how much you have to spend and whatnot. Equipment, very kind of self-explanatory stuff. But yeah, let me show you kind of a setup of like what I have real quick, and then I'm probably gonna end, even though I've only been streaming a little long, or only it's like 30 minutes. That whole annoyance kind of messed me up, so. No, we don't need to save. All right, so. This will be my next tutorial. This is what I'm kind of working on. But if we go to the layout tool, so layout tool is like we have the status holder, which I made is just a renderer. It's actually blank, but it's there. I just put it there so I can have a size reference. But hide it. Name, you get. You can write there or you can put your party name, but I'll go over that in the tutorial and everything. I'm not going to go too in depth. But here's like your state changes. These are like if you get poisoned and whatnot. And to show like an enemy variable or if you want to show like the enemy's information, it's right here. I hold all my information in an array because it's a lot easier to access. You're talking about for container management? No sugar. So like when I get in the map, see it loads everyone's information properly. There's skeletons, HP, MP, and all that. I hold it all in arrays. I did, but I can go over it for you again real quick. It's not hard. Let's see, battle cam. So like this is a moving by delta time, which is like this. I made just a simple little map event, and then you have to put it into a loop, and then whenever. Oh, okay. But yeah, I did go over that. Part of it, but whenever you're in this loop, you will turn on a battle cam switch, or you can make a variable for multiple cameras and everything. You're gonna want to just disable all this, but like I said, I'll go over more of this whenever I get to the tutorial. But this is how. The new camera system works. You can change the camera parameters and everything. I don't know why that's one. That should be zero. Why are you gonna die of exhaustion, Hydons? Oh, hang on. Let me put more out there. There you go. So delta time here. So I assigned the previous elapsed time from previous frame to this delta variable, multiply it by 15 because I'm increasing it by 15 increments, or you can do 5, which is a lot slower, and then you add that to the cam time, whatnot. Anyways. But yeah, this is gonna be good job, Hydrolins. This will be this file will be part of the turn-based battle system tutorial and everything. It's kind of hard to go over the free layout events. You kind of need to just go through it yourself. Like, I have my event set up like this. Like, I have their, so here's, if, Evo, if you're still watching, here's one way you can grab the enemy's information, is you can put it into a variable or an array, and assign it to a string variable, and you can show it in Bakin. Did I mess up somewhere? No. But I'm gonna go over more over the arrays when I work on the tutorial, because we really don't have much on it, and people, I think, are getting confused a little bit on it. And let's see. Save that. Ooh, excuse me. So I think that's the end of the tutorial. But so I was playing with, if it's still here, did I delete it? So here I'll show you what I was talking about, Hydrolins, with the camera. Or the cursor movement? No, not this. Is this it? No, that's something else. I'll do it real quick. Cursor. That's cursor one. Move hats. Move Y. There at player Y. Okay. So, like, no, he's Katara, man. All right. So, why, and then. And then divide that by 100. Yeah. Same thing for Y. Divide that. Alright. Because that's the only way you can actually do it properly. Because, here, I'll show you. If you do it that way, you can see that it doesn't have like an absurd number But the problem with all that is, like, no, oops, not that. And if you were to move the player, let's see, player, let's see, where was it? Yeah. Let's see him walk. So you almost kind of have cursor movement. Not really, though. You see? It's weird. It almost works. But I think we need like a... Yeah. Ooh, there it goes. No, not that. Let me name that HUD. It's out of my way. And I've tried doing like a distance check between the character on screen, not their actual XY values. But that don't work too well. Let me try this real quick. Okay, so that... Screen... And then if this helps. And then P adds, subtract, no, cursor adds, nope, move adds from P adds, that's the one. Yeah, let's just make this easier so I don't have to keep looking. Ooh.
you there. Okay. That's fine. All right. And then move ads. All right, let's see if this works. Probably not. Nope. Oh, he's gone. Oh, that froze. That crashes Bakin. That's funny. That's different. We'll do this. Nope. Cut. No, mouse. F click. Okay, so let's see. Ooh, yeah, look at that. Look at those numbers. Let's try this. Let's see. Kinda. Just realized too that,
All right, let's see. Oh, you know why? I know what I'm doing wrong. I'll have to play with this later. But it's trying to move to the coordinates, not... Go ahead and stop it here. Thank you all for watching, and I will be hopefully uploading the tutorial in the next week or so. So see y'all in the